Hello and welcome to another watercolour demonstration where I'm going to paint this little scene of Mont Saint Michel. We're going to paint it on a full sheet. So 30 inches by 22 inches, which is 76 centimetres by 56 centimetres. So let's go. Okay, so I've got my board at about a 45 degree angle. Ideally 30 would be better, but so the camera can see what I'm doing. That's why I've got a slightly steeper angle. I shall just have to allow for things that the water may run down the page a bit quicker. So, covering a large area. So I'm going to use this big brush. Don't ask me what it is. It's just from local depot store. So it's nothing fancy, but holds a lot of paint. Well, it can cover a big area. It doesn't actually hold a lot of paint, really. It's probably not ideal. Keep reloading it. I'm definitely going to need to spray it because it's hot today up here in the grange. Reload that brush. I need to make sure I go dark enough with it. Bring that down to about here. Start to produce a bit of red, which is a little bit there, so we use that. Just warming it up now. Paint up into there. So this is just the first wash, just to set the scene. I'm going for this, same as on my little painting I did for the live stream. Just a bit of warmth. And so this is a full sheet of paper and I'm using 140-pound Saunders and Waterford. A bit of texture. I shall leave a bit of white sparkle there. I shall need to let that dry. I'll use a hairdryer to speed things up. Start at the top and just use the hardware brush. It's falling apart, hairs everywhere. Start at the top and work my way down. So I'm using a combination of various photos of Mont Saint Michel for the detail and mainly my previous painting here, because I want to keep that looseness. So go to perler brush, will give me a nice point. This, all I've done there is I've just a bit of double-sided tape, stick watercolor paper there, so I need to rest my hand on the paper, but because it's hot up here, my sweaty hand will probably damage the paper. So plenty of paint on the brush here, so I can all of this. I shall have two brushes on the go. Use a bit of clean water. Run down. Create a bit of light. The light source coming from this side. Here, mowers in the background. Hopefully the noise cancelling on my ear will cut that out for us. Let's go into a bit of this blue, which I'm using indigo blue and dusk pink. Darker here, side, but the little painting worked well because I let it mix on the paper, so that's what I'm going to do again. Make sure I keep picking up lots of paint. Reload. Put this bead of water. Go on about that all the time. Yes. No. Sound advice. They're slow going
doing this, but it'll be worth it. Tissue in my hand as well to control amount of water on this brush. I shall use a bit of yellow ochre as well and a touch of red.
I've got warmth here as well. Again, thing, lime, paper. Make any mistakes? Fortunately, what about them? Beauty of watercolour. Tragedy of it that
not very forgiving if you make a mistake.
Secret is don't make mistakes. If I don't worry about the detail,
on a larger painting like this, I do need to have more detail than what I had on the previous one, because it won't hold up otherwise, I don't think. So, spray, just keep it moist. Without my hand on the paper.
A little bit of a highlight there. That.
Clean my brush off because I want the light to be clean.
Light. Throw some that bit. Nice and decent. Wet into wet. I can firm up some of these details towards the end.
Back in with that blue.
Side.
So far, so good.
Throw a bit of water on there. So I need to paint some windows and so on here, but if I try to do it now, it will they'll just disperse too much. Go to a bigger brush.
This indigo blue is what I used on the previous painting. It worked quite well for this side of the building
out. Away with painting no detail on this side at all, pretty much.
We'll need plenty of water. Didn't want to do that. I've just managed to spray a load of stuff on there, but can't do anything about it. What, I sprayed too close to that and it sprayed the background there. So it is what it is. No point getting stressed about it. Which is why it's good. I used a projector to do this image that in time. Projector to do the image. If I spent 2 hours drawing this, probably would have been a bit upset. Took me 5 minutes drawing. Main reason I used the projector was A, to show patron projector if you're not comfortable drawing it. But also, it's
a smart way of working, I think. Got a lot of demos to get through today, tomorrow, or over this weekend. So
I want to spend hours drawing. Time spent doing the painting is productive for me. It all depends on your reasoning. Trying to learn drawing techniques, it's a good idea to draw it freehand. Maybe grid it up or something like that. Right. Down here. It threw me off that little bit there, but it probably won't even be noticeable, to be fair. But it's just me worrying about it. Right from a distance, gently. So I need to end up with a bead down here. Back to some warmth on this side over here. Again, that yellow ochre, touch of red. Plenty of water. We need translucent washes. Got some light there. Buildings. Paint up into this before it dries. But then I was planning on doing more detail like this, but there just isn't the time for the work so quickly. Can't do it sometimes. Nice and dark there for that building. Bit of light there. Let's take that. Oh, I know what I have done. I've forgotten to put the blue in afterwards. Busy setting up my cameras and worrying about my microphone working. Still. Challenge. Question of there. So before this dries, I do in a bit of now.
Yes. So I need strong paint.
So we've got some trees going across here. Needs to be done wet into wet, otherwise it will just look stuck on. Something in there. So bigger paintings are trickier because you just got to work so much quicker. Eliminate a lot of this detail that isn't necessary. Tricky, but have to go with that and suggest some windows and things towards that. Finish with a bead down here. Give it a spray. Now take some clean water and say it worked quite well when I wet the bottom of this. Create fusion of water, let it run down, create that softness. Give it a little spray. I'll have a go at putting the distant purple hill in. Get the right colour. Probably mauve. I've got some mauve here. Yeah. Right. with it. Lump of paint there. It's not gone well, this painting. Been without its troubles, so to say. I take some clean water and just wet that above there so I get a soft edge. Yeah. Must be a little bit on the dark side. It'll dry a little bit lighter. Brush is falling off the table. So what happens with watercolour, when things don't go your way, everything falls apart. Wet this. Lumps of paint on this brush that's really messed me up, that has. Why? Fresh paint all the time. Paint that's been in here. Palette for a while and it's just dried up. Any problems? So I need to talk to a bit of sponge here to help rescue. Right, have another go. Brush. Awesome. Yeah, by the painting a little bit maybe. Give it a spray. We'll just let that carry on doing that. So is there anything I could put in while it's damp? I put some of these darks in. This is a hopefully a good example of don't give up, keep going, not over yet. So maybe that's more tree shapes here. We have a little bit of detail. Nice how that's worked. These darks. Yeah. Something for the eye to grab hold of. Looking at shapes. There's like so many houses. Be able to paint them all unless I really drew every individual house out and concentrate on that kind of level of detail, which is not what I'm trying to do. But sometimes you'll sacrifice a bit of detail for nice bits of detail. Trees here. Careful, don't lose. That run down. Go for lots of atmosphere. If I do all this wet into wet, should hopefully get away with that. There. Yeah. I did that. Let's give it a little spray, one last spray. Let's put the foreground in. Mix up all of this. Burnt sienna. Need to make sure I go dark enough with this. Keep on the same colour theme. So now that works. So, with that indigo blue, it is a staining colour, so I have to be careful. You know, that run that went down that that would stain the paper, but I have got away with that. About. A little bit darker. Bottom here. Right. I think I'll use my sponge. Better to carry that off page. A lead in. Can get away with doing stuff like this with a sponge. Struggle probably to lift out that much with the brush. Final spray. So I still think I need just a little bit of detail. Hard edge here. Hard edge will give that illusion of detail. Here, maybe just a couple of windows. A suggestion there. Need just a few of these. That'll be enough to hopefully create that illusion that there's something there. There isn't really, it's just pretty colours. Careful because it won't take a lot, just make it look a mess. Pick out the odd a tree, stop. trees, those. Mess a little bit of that up with some water. Great believer in suggesting detail. In houses and those and things. Not a great mess here, so let's put a few in here. Bird there. Pterodactyls. Got a video about not painting pterodactyls.
Where? All right.
Bit of dry brush just to create that illusion of texture, but really do need to stop, I think. Just put a little bit of, I think I'm going to go for putting a hard edge here. It worked well in the other painting, so let's have a go. Darken it here. At the fiddling stage now, where I should let it be and. Of the day, let's just throw some water on here, create some stuff. So let's take the tape off. But there you go, a nice big painting. And again, I've not gone overly detailed with it, but just that's a little bit more detail than the little painting, but just captured the same atmosphere. But I think it deserved to go large, as it's, you know, a very impressive mount. So the small painting perhaps, you know, was a good idea, and then turned the idea into a big idea. So let me know in the comments what you think. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and I shall see you on the next one.